Wilson, it is working.
Get away from there! You'll ruin everything!
You have to short-circuit his brain. It is the only way to stop him.
Great. Easier said than done. Okay, fake heart. Time to do
this. I'm going to overload his electrodes. He won't be able to obey my commands. Andrew! No! I did this for you. What are you doing?
Elsa! It's over for both of us, Andy.
Welcome back, Wilson.
Yeah, thanks.
So, that was a truly terrifying experience, would you not say?
That's gotta be the understatement of the year. But, you know, what happened to everybody else?
Yes, Elsa and Lucy are both deceased. Elsa's son, Andrew, is also gone. I tried to save his brain, but its activity ceased once his body became non-functional. One bright spot, however, is that the hospital has been restored back to normal. We are operating at almost full capacity again.
What about that goddamn teddy bear? Is it dead?
No. There is still no teddy bear. Let us perhaps not mention that to the hospital psychologist that may want to speak to you later on, all right?
And Kurt?
Mr. Mosby is missing. There is no sign of him. Local law enforcement are still looking for his body.
What happened to the device? Did you destroy it?
After the fires were put out in the laboratory, I searched everywhere for it, but it was gone. Hopefully it was destroyed in the explosion, but Wilson, I do not know for sure.
Well, if it hasn't, that could spell trouble for whoever finds it.
We will deal with it, Wilson, I promise. But for now, take a moment to enjoy that your heart has been put back in its rightful place. Your chest. The procedure was a complete success. Your recovery should go very smoothly.
Yeah, about that. Look, Vela, I'm having my heart taken out again.
What are you talking about? When?
Right now, actually. When I woke up earlier, I asked one of the nurses to bring you here. I wanted to tell you myself.
After everything you have been through to retrieve your heart, why?
You see that guy over there?
Yes, and?
His name is William. William Herman Wilson, my brother.
It is lovely that you have a brother, Wilson, but I still do not understand what this has to do with removing your heart.
Bela, I wasn't supposed to wake up, meet you, or any of the others. I volunteered for the surgery so that this heart could replace my brother's damaged one.
What is wrong with him? Do you know?
Some type of coronary disease. It hit him hard and fast. He and his wife knew that there wasn't a lot of time left. His only chance was to try a radical new surgery, the first of its kind. A heart transplant.
I understand wanting to save someone you love and care about. Please believe me when I say that. But do you really think this is the best option? Is there not another way?
There's a bright 10-year-old little girl waiting in the other room that doesn't want to grow up without her father. That's all that matters. There's nothing else to think about.
And your brother? He is content with this? Allowing you to give your life for his?
No. He wouldn't have gone through with it if he knew what I was. It was the only way.
I see.
Listen, I know that we just met. But if he ever found out where his new heart came from, it would... Do you think you could? I mean, would you?
I will take care of it. You have my word.
Thank you.
If I am to do you this favor, there is something I must know.
Name it.
Did you think I was the vampire? Attacking the people that Lucy murdered?
Hell yes, I did. Have you looked in the mirror lately?
I would not know. I do not cast a reflection.
Yeah.
It has been an honor, Robert.
Goodbye, Bella.
Hell of a day, yes?
Yeah. Hell of a day.
Nurse, please make sure he is as comfortable as possible, whatever he needs.
Yes, of course, Doctor. Mr. Wilson? The doctor is ready to move forward with the procedure. It's time. Are you ready?
Yeah. I'm ready.
Breathe normally and try to relax. It won't take long.
Oh.
Mr. Mosby, I presume?
Yeah, that's me.
Good. Very good. Lovely this time of year. The air has a certain crispness to it. Something about that. Brilliant.
So, you do exist?
Of course, my boy. You did contact us, after all, did you not?
I mean, yeah.
Now that we are both familiar with each other, let's get down to it. Do you have the object?
Yeah, I got it.
Do show Mr. Mosby.
Hey, you know, just don't be so damn pushy.
Incredible. And what of the journal?
It's destroyed. Wilson wanted to make sure it never got...
Yes, Wilson, the man who used this. I am sorry that he didn't make it.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Well, without Harcourt's journal, this will definitely prove more difficult to crack. But not impossible.
So how long before you figure that thing out and help me with my problem?
You'll need patience, my boy. This is the most complex device the world has ever known. It will take time.
Yeah, well, time isn't exactly something on my side.
A good point. I believe the moon is to be full tomorrow night. You do have somewhere to put yourself, I would hope.
Look, man, it's like I told your people, or whoever they are. Since the first time, I haven't killed anyone. I'll lock myself up and everybody's safe from me.
Good. Good for you. I've been after your kind for a long time, son. As well as others. And believe me when I tell you that a night will come when you don't have a safe place and there is nowhere to hide, you will kill again. Believe me.
Is this a joke? You and your group, or your order, or whatever the hell you call them, were supposed to help me. We had a deal.
Well, that is the goal, yes? That is all, Mr. Mosby. Thank you for your time. We will certainly do our best.
But that's it? How am I supposed to find you?
Not to worry, son. We'll find you. Good day.
Yeah, great.
Oh, and Mr. Mosby, do keep your nightly activities from becoming local news. We will be watching. Such lovely weather.